How's it going, everyone? I'm Nostalgia Dave, and welcome back aboard the Nostalgia Train. So, at the request of a couple individuals, including, more notably, Stobo Comedo Pro, I am going to be taking a look at Game Builder Garage. This is a blind playthrough, so like always, it'll be trimmed at the beginning, trimmed at the end, but you guys will see everything otherwise. So I guess we have to start with the interactive lessons based off the what's shaded and what's not. Grab the apple. Okay, L to move. Cool. B to jump. Hello? Is this normal? Hello? I can't jump, apparently. What's with the weird look? Oh, yeah, talking duck. Kind of strange. Got it. I mean, yeah, that's one strange thing of what's going on right now. I should introduce myself. You can call me... You can call me Bow! Glad that's out of the way. Let me just say, I understand your frustration. Can't finish this simple game, right? You can't jump by pressing B. Yeah, I'm pressing B and nothing's happening. But there's a good reason for all that. See, thing is, this game is still under construction. The way it is now, you'll never beat the game, no matter how many times you try to jump. Okay. In situations like this, I like to say, don't get mad. Get programming. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We need to do a deep dive into this game to wrap things up. We need to peek behind the curtain, so to speak. So, why don't we do that right now? Okay. If it isn't our Bob. Good to see you, dear.
Hey, Bob!
Hi.
Woohoo! Hi, Bob!
Boing!
Welcome to the inside of the game. So, you want to know about our friends here? These beings are called Nodon. There are all kinds of different Nodon living inside your Nintendo Switch.
What?
I'm reading it? I'm just too perplexed to be able to actually verbally say what I'm reading out loud. This place where we use Nodon to do programming has a nifty little name. It's called the Motherboard. The Game Builder Garage. That little fragment of a game you played earlier was programmed in the Game Builder Garage. It wasn't finished! Let's get down to business. We'll use the Game Builder Garage to finish this game. What's with the blank look? I don't... See the output port on the... yeah?
Heyo, I'm Button Nordon.
Okay. That's kind of what I figured you wanted from me.
Presto! We made it so pressing B makes the character jump.
Now we should be able to complete the game.
Okay.
Oh, well, hey, look at that.
You did it! Great job!
Yay!
Got to finish building a game with a bit of programming.
Why don't we pop back in? Okay. I got questions. It's fun learning how to program a game, right?
Actually, I think you might have a real knack for this.
I don't think so.
How about it? Do you want to program some more?
Sure, I guess. Maybe you'd be interested in your new pal Bob's interactive lessons. Like just now, you go through. Okay. Sure. Seven games in these. Okay.
Steve, hang on a sec. My name's Alice. So, not Bob. He's the excitable one you already met. I look similar, but I'm Alice.
Well, you're pink. He's blue.
Please don't forget or call me Bob or anything like that.
Don't plan on it.
You know how you got that game to work just now? Be honest. You don't really get what made it work, right?
Okay, yeah, I don't.
I mean, that's totally fine. You just started with all this stuff. You know, if you're going to make your own game, you'll need to understand which
Yeah. I'm not good with that stuff.
That's why I set up some checkpoints to help you. I'd like you to come to the checkpoint before lesson one.
Okay.
Stopping by. The idea here is to test whether you really know your programming stuff.
That's fair. Okay.
I have something for you that I think will help. Your very own guide. This will give you further tips on how to use Nodon to make games.
And I'll give you the band. Okay. Person jumped. Let's take a peek around the back and see other side of the okay. It beeps. Oh, it's that programmer again.
Hey, yo! Hey, I remember you. Looking forward to bashing some buttons with you.
Okay. That's right, the person that you saw back then was the person known on Steam. Take note of the position of the person Nodon on the program screen here. The location of the person Nodon determines the location of the person on the game screen. Well, that makes sense. If you were to move me over to the right of the program screen, How do you think that looks? topics on the game screen. Okay. Another thing to know about the program screen is that you can scroll it to find more space. Okay. Let's put the screen back to how it was before. Okay then. Back to the main topic. I want to make the person jump. I'm connected to the button node on C. These lines here represent the connection. Yeah, I know. I actually kind of appreciate the fact that they're putting like little checkpoints to make sure you know what you're doing, because I have no idea, and we're only gonna get through this in this episode because of how short I'm making these episodes specifically. To understand the signal, try thinking of a very. This is interesting though. Okay. I get a signal in my jump port. I know, basically. Okay, so. Let me just sum it up. I'd rather A be jump and B be like interact or something. Or vice versa. I don't know. Okay. Remove the connection between the node on and see what happens. Oh, it's not the button X, it's okay. It's like a cross. Okay. Let's go to the game screen and see what changed. Okay. If there's no connection, then the signal won't reach the person node on when it B is pressed. So that's why the person didn't jump when you pressed B. Sure. There it is! I'm getting signal from the node on. Okay. Alright. This is going to be interesting to try to get into. Gosh. Lessons. Bore me to yawning. Once you understand how things work in the background, you really start to look at them differently, huh? Sure. You'll be seeing a lot of us. Okay. Thanks, I guess. Now I'm going to test your knowledge of the basics of the puzzle challenge. Okay. Okay. Shut up, I get it. Make sure. Oh my gosh! Ta-da! That was so hard. Well, lesson one done. No, and I'll be testing how well you know Game Builder Garage and the Node on. has anything that's not clear, feel free to hit up Alice's Guide. There's nothing holding you back, so let's go get to lesson one. Not this time. I'm actually gonna leave this here. These are gonna be shorter videos, but I do want to get through all of it from beginning to end to make sure I understand all of it. And then once we're done with this, I don't know, maybe we can do some like other games and stuff. Or I don't know, maybe they're just like self-played and that's it. We'll figure it out later. Either way, thank you guys so much for watching this episode, this beginner episode of Game Builder Garage. So far, I'm enjoying it. It's interesting. It's kind of like its own self-building only version of Super Mario Maker, which I'll have to get back into at some point. Maybe. We'll see. But if you like this video, make sure to push that like button, and so far you can't see it anymore. And if you really like it, consider subscribing to the channel. Have a suggestion for a game you'd like to see on here? Once again, like this one, which was suggested several times, and I was planning on doing it, now I'm doing it. But if you want something like that to happen for a game you may have in mind that gives you nostalgia, let us know in the comments below, we'll get to it when we can. Secondly, if you want to check out... Actually, before I say that, once again, I want to give a shout-out to Stone Mokamita Pro for suggesting this game. We'll try to get through it as much as we can. See what creative things we can come up with as well. At the end of it, if we do, we'll see. We'll definitely at least get through all of these. But if you want to check out any other stuff that has been done here creatively, I guess specifically Super Mario Maker 2, click the link at the bottom right-hand corner, or try and take you to that destination. If you miss any of the stops on this right, click the link across my head here and try and take you there. In the meantime, this train's off to its next destination, but we hope to catch you guys in another ride. Bye!